Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I will show you how to bind local and remote data to the React ListBox component. Let's jump right into the coding. I will open my existing sample, where I have installed the Syncfusion React dropdowns package. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic ListBox rendering code. If you need to know how to create a basic React ListBox, you can refer to my Getting Started video link in the card above or in the description below. Data can be bound to the ListBox using the DataSource property. First, I assign the array of string values such as badminton, cricket, football, golf, tennis, etc. I also need to map the value and text fields when binding the data. When binding an array of simple data, both text and value fields will be considered the same. Let me run this application. Look here, the list box displays array of string values. I can also bind a JSON array to the list box. In data.js file, define a JSON object, naming it employees, with fields, name, employee ID, designation, and country. Then import this object in app.tsx page from the data.js file and assign it to the data source property. Next, I need to map the JSON object fields to the value and text fields using the fields property. Here, I map the employee ID field to the value property and name field to the text property. See here, the list box is rendered with the provided JSON object. Now, I will show you how to bind complex data. In the data.js file, I will do a slight modification, like adding a new field, employee details, and show the name, designation, and country fields inside that new field. Now just change the text property value to employeeDetails.name. See, the array of complex data object is shown here. Finally, to bind remote data, I use the Syncfusion Data Manager. I import the data manager from the namespace ej2data. Then, I declare the variable remote data and create an instance of the data manager to provide the service endpoint URL using the URL property and assign the remote data link. Let's have a look at the remote data. It has four fields: employee ID, first name, etc. To make the server understand the request and process the response, you need to specify the adapter type. You can refer to the different adapter types in the UG link provided in the description below. Here, I'll use the Web API adapter and enable the cross-domain option. I assign this variable to the data source property. Then map the first name field to the data source property. Declare another variable, data query, and create an instance of query to specify the field name to be fetched from the remote data. Assign this to the query property in the list box. Check now, the list box is rendered with the remote data. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to bind local and remote data to the React list box component. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.